Welcome to our continuity practice here. I was just before sitting down here, I happened to look at this orange tree in a pot we have. And this orange tree has quite a history. It was put in the backyard in a shady place, in a bad place. It got neglected and it got completely run down and was basically looked like it was almost dead. And it was in the most sorrowful shape you've ever seen. And it was really, I was ready to throw it out. I mean, year after year, it just got more and more skinny and more decrepit. And it was a pathetic thing to see. And I said, you know, this, what do we do? What do I do? I said, you know what? Let's give it a chance. Let's just see. Let's change something here. Let's change its location. Let's put it in a new pot, bigger pot, change its location, give it good dirt, give it some fertilizer. Let's see if we can bring this plant back from the dead. It was so neglected, so terribly neglected, really. It's one of those things, right, that happens. It's sometimes some things get neglected in our life. There's always something that's getting neglected. Well, I just took a look at it, and it is now just absolutely bursting with blossoms, orange blossoms. It is the picture of radiant health, and the picture, and there's oranges, beautiful oranges on it, and it's just like, I just said, oh my gosh. Look, I hadn't really noticed it that much. It just, look at this. Look at this tree that's come back from the dead, really. And it's now just flowering and fruiting so amazingly. So, I feel very strongly in the neglected, that which has been neglected, that they can be brought back to extreme, wonderful perfection. And who are the neglected? We are. We are the neglected. Because we've been neglecting ourselves. We have been neglecting ourselves. Terribly. Terribly. We are unbelievably negligent of what we truly are. We are in a deep coma of forgetfulness. But we can be brought back out of that coma to full, true spiritual health. Absolutely can. And so what a amazing, wonderful thing just to see that. I don't even know how to feel about it. It's just like a miracle. Just a miracle. It's completely bursting everywhere. These beautiful scented orange blossoms compared to what it used to be, which was the most pathetic thing you've ever seen. So we can do it. And I enjoy doing that. I have the will to do that. If I see something that's neglected, I say, you know what, that can be brought back. It can. Don't give up on it. So let's not give up on ourselves. Absolutely do not give up on ourselves. We can do it through right spiritual practice. And we are going to do that right spiritual practice right now. We are going to continue with what we do in this case, calling to mind the qualities of God's light of remembrance, the lovely light of remembrance that bathes everything, that rests upon everything, that touches everything. When we decide to accept it, we will see it. When we're ready to accept it, we will see it. We have a saying here, we'll believe it when we see it, but we should turn that around and say, we'll see it when we believe it. We'll see it when we're ready to see it. We'll see it when our belief is sufficiently attuned to it. When our belief is valuing it and attuned to it and expecting it and has a comfort zone with it, that is when we will see it. And that is when our tree of remembrance will be full of these fragrant blossoms. And it will happen. We can bring ourselves back from the dead. The death of forgetfulness is what it really is. So let us go over these qualities that call to mind this God's lovely light of remembrance. This God's lovely light of remembrance is inexpressible. 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 It cannot be pressed into some expression. It cannot be captured by any expression. It is ineffably inexpressible. God's lovely light of remembrance is concept free. There is not a trace. that is engaged in conceptualizing anything. It is not conceptualizing anything whatsoever. There are no concepts. It is concept-free. God's lovely light of remembrance is non-stratified. It's not stratified in all these layers, sediment layers being laid down. There's no stratification whatsoever. No stratification in this lovely light of remembrance. God's lovely light of remembrance is inside free, outside free. There's no sense like, I've discovered the inside of this light, and over there is the outside of this light. It is inside free, outside free. Just as it is, just like that. God's lovely light of remembrance is non-linear. There's no sense of some linear, here, and it's here, and it's here, and it's here, and there's something linear about it. No. It's total, it is whole, it is holy, it is non-linear. God's lovely light of remembrance is overflowing, 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 totally overflowing itself, as it were. Meaning there's no boundary, no sense of, this is where it ends. It's always perpetually overflowing. God's light of loveliness is full. It is totally full. There's a sense of complete fullness to it. It's not 99% full. It is 100% full. Always and forever 100% full. Full. God's light of loveliness is zero dimensional. You know, you look at it, you get a sense like, there's not some dimension here and dimension here to it and another here, another there. And no, it is zero dimensional. Just is what it is, zero dimensional. God's light of loveliness is pure spaciousness. Pure spaciousness. Pure spaciousness. Not some space, but pure spaciousness. God's light of loveliness is decay free. There is no decay taking place whatsoever. Anywhere, no sense of decay. Not even the slightest trace of decay. God's light of loveliness is zero density. Zero density. We don't say, there's greater density here, and there's lesser density here, and there's all this play of density. No, zero density. It's full, but it has a feeling of zero density to it. There's no play of density. Density free. God's light of loveliness is nameless. It is nameless. There is no name that you can put upon it. God's light of loveliness is not naming itself. It's not naming what it rests upon. It's not naming you. It's not naming me. The name of God is one. Just one name upon all. It is nameless. God's light of loveliness is pattern free. There are no patterns at play in this light. It's not patterning itself this way or patterning itself this way. It is entirely free of any patterns. God's light of loveliness, God's lovely light of remembrance is non-prismatic. It is not something that can be split up in a prismatic way that you could there's some prism there that you're seeing through, or it can be seen through a prism. It is non-prismatic. It's not like light, you can split it up with a prism. It is totally clear light. It is non-prismatic. God's light of loveliness is non-tailored. There is no sense that it's being cleverly, adroitly stitched here and tailored here and to suit something. It is a sense of complete, seamless non-tailoredness. It is non-tailored. God's light of loveliness is non-migrating. There is no sense of migration. It is not migrating in here, migrating over there, needing to migrate ever. It is totally everywhere, resting upon everything as it is, without any migration. God's light of loveliness is non-drifting. There is no sense of drift whatsoever. Even a soft drift, even a gentle drift, is not drifting somewhere. Not even imperceptibly drifting. There is no drift to it whatsoever. It is non-drifting. God's light of loveliness is non-precipitating. There's nothing being precipitated. It's not precipitating in any way, shape, or form. It is completely immune to being pulled into any sort of precipitation whatsoever. God's light of loveliness is non-washable. You cannot wash it. You cannot put in a washing machine. You cannot Spray it with a hose and wash it. You cannot wash it in any way. It is non-washable. God's lovely light of remembrance is unbleachable. You cannot throw something on it and bleach it. You cannot fade it, bleach it, do anything to change it in any way. It is unbleachable. God's light of loveliness is non-absorbent. It is not absorbing anything. It is non-absorbent. It is not absorbing anything that it rests upon. Completely non-absorbent. God's light of loveliness is dust-free. There is no dust. No dust falling and collecting on it. Even the tiniest little dust particles. No dust. God's light of loveliness is non-flammable. It cannot burn. There is no way to torch it. No way to make it catch on fire whatsoever. It is non-flammable. God's light of loveliness is non-material. There's no material quality to it whatsoever. There's nothing about it that we can say, this is a material quality. None. It is non-material. God's light of loveliness is unerodible. It cannot be eroded away. There is nothing that can gradually work on it to gradually imperceptibly erode it. Not even the tiniest imperceptible erosion can ever take place. God's light of lovely light of remembrance is weather free. There are no weather systems. There is no weather happening whatsoever. You cannot say this one steady state that is just one totality cannot have. It has no weather in it. It is simply remains as it is. God's light, lovely light of remembrance is pressure free. Pressure free. There's no sense of pressure. There's no pressure systems. There are no pressure gradients. There are no pressure gradients whatsoever. God's lovely light of remembrance has no pressure gradients. It is pressure gradient free. God's lovely light of remembrance is unsaturated. There's no sense that it's saturated here. There's some saturation taking place. Say, that's saturated. Not even a sense, even though it's full, it's unsaturated. There's no sense of saturation. God's lovely light of remembrance is unopposed. There is no sense of opposition in it. No sense of opposition whatsoever. No opposition. Unopposed. God's lovely light of remembrance is non-busy. No busyness. No sense it's busy doing something. It's, I'm busy. No. Freely unoccupied. It's just resting upon everything. No sense of busyness at all. God's lovely light of remembrance is untargeted. There's no way to target it. It has no target. You can't target it. Nothing can target it. This is a target. You can't turn it into a target. It cannot be targeted. God's lovely light of remembrance is non-stealthy. No sense of stealth there. Is it stealthy? No. Absolutely no sneaky, stealthy slyness at all to it. It is totally non-stealthy. God's lovely light of remembrance is unabridged. It is unabridged. It is the unabridged, inherently unabridged. There's no abridgment to it. There's no, let's get the cliff notes to it. It's trying to, abridge itself, so it'll give you the short version. It is unabridged. All of it is there. All of it is there. It is all there. It is all there. God's lovely light of remembrance is non-quantitative. It cannot be quantified in any way. You can say, I can get a sense of how much there is. There's the quantity. It is entirely non-quantitative. You cannot get any sense of any quantity. There's no sense of quantity to it at all. God's lovely light of remembrance is destination free. There is no sense that there's some destination to arrive in. It doesn't have any destinations to it. You look and say, is there a city, a town, no destination. Destination free. God's lovely light of remembrance is shadow free. There are no shadows to it. It casts no shadow. It casts no shadow upon itself, no shadow upon anything. It is shadow free. God's lovely light of remembrance is death free. Is death free. There is not the slightest indication or sense of any death of any kind whatsoever. It is entirely death free. God's lovely light remembrance is accident free. There are no accidents. No accidents can happen. There is not any accidents at all in God's lovely light of remembrance. Accident free. God's lovely light of remembrance is despair free. No despair. Nothing to despair. No sense of despair whatsoever. Totally despair free. God's lovely light of remembrance is sickness free. No sickness. Not a trace of sickness can be found. Not a trace of sickness can ever be even remotely discerned in the tiniest trace way. Sickness free. God's lovely light of remembrance is pain free. There is no pain within it. No pain whatsoever. Entirely pain free. Not the slightest trace of pain whatsoever. God's lovely light of remembrance is deception free. There is no deception in it. There is zero deception in it. No sense of deception whatsoever. Deception free. God's lovely light of remembrance is projection free. It is not projecting anything. It is entirely free of all projection. Entirely free of all projection. God's lovely light of remembrance is fear free. There is no fear in it. There is no trace of fear in God's lovely light of remembrance. God's lovely light of remembrance is confusion free. Confusion free. There is no confusion in it. No confusion. Nothing being confused. Totally devoid of any confusion. God's lovely light of remembrance is unbuilt. There is nothing built. There's nothing built into it. It's not built up. There's nothing built. It is unbuilt. Unbuilt. God's lovely light of remembrance is non-segmented. There aren't any segments to it. There are no segments. It is seamless. It is smoothly seamless. No segments. It is unsegmented. God's lovely light of remembrance is mutation free. Mutation free. It cannot be mutated. It cannot undergo any type of mutation whatsoever. It is 100% wholly what it is, exactly as it is now, forever. It cannot undergo any mutation. God's lovely light of remembrance is unblocked. There's nothing blocking it. There are no blocks within it. No blocks. It is unblocked. Block free. God's lovely light of remembrance is lie free. There are no lies in it. There are no trace of a lie in it. It is perfectly what it is. There is no lie in it. It is lie free. God's lovely light of remembrance is not coming nor going. There is no coming and there is no going taking place within God's lovely light of remembrance. Nothing is coming. It is not coming. It is not coming somewhere. It is not going somewhere. It is not coming from somewhere. It is not going to somewhere. No coming and going. God's lovely light of remembrance is unshrinking. Unshrinking. There is no shrinkage of it. It's not shrinking. It's not shrinking from anything. It's not shrinking into itself. It is not pulling away. It is not contracting. It is not shrinking. There is no shrinkage. It is shrinkage free. God's lovely light of remembrance is non-dominating. It is not dominating anything. There's no sense that it's dominating. That it needs to dominate anything, that there's anything that is being dominated at all. It is totally domination-free, non-dominating. Okay. Just like that. We've gone over the qualities of God's lovely light of remembrance. Some of the qualities, just tuning in, just trying to tune that radio in, as it were, too. It seems like a broadcast, a faint broadcast, and we're trying to fine-tune it. We've got all these real fine-tuning knobs, and we're saying, okay, the broadcast comes in like this. So we are detaching ourselves from all the material qualities of this world, all the qualities that we're suffering from here. And we're saying, you know, the light of loveliness of remembrance, God's lovely light of remembrance, is free of all those noxious qualities, is free of all those troublesome qualities. Entirely so. Entirely. We're attuning our expectations, getting our comfort zone where it needs to be. And that's what practice is all about, getting our comfort zone where it needs to be. And it doesn't happen unless we actually use our will to get it to happen. We have to use our will to move our comfort zone, to shape our comfort zone, to put our comfort zone in the right place. Otherwise, we'll just keep on wallowing in this materiality and suffering from all of these things that just bother us so much and complaining about them. Complaining doesn't do any good. They won't go anywhere. We have to build our comfort zone so that the vision of oneness now, it fits into that comfort zone. Our comfort zone is there for it. Our comfort zone is there for it. Okay, very great. That's it for this continuity practice video.